We've already done a lot of the steps required to solve the 3-sat problem in this course. We've seen how to represent 3-sat, the input that is. We've also seen how to apply preprocessing rules so that it's a bit easier to solve after that. And these are mainly in problem sets 2 and 4. Now what we're going to do is construct a search tree to find if the given instance has a satisfying assignment. So you're going to code up a function solve3sat that should return none if the given instance of 3sat has no satisfying assignment, and otherwise it should return that satisfying assignment. Now the search tree technique that we're going to use is as follows. We're going to take any clause that is not satisfied, and if all of the variables have already been set, then there's no possible solution anymore, so simply return none. Otherwise, we branch into at most 3 cases, where in each case a different variable is set, so that the clause can hopefully become satisfied. The first variable is set so that clause becomes satisfied and we don't do anything with the other variables. The first variable is set so that clause does not become satisfied, and the second one is set so that it becomes satisfied, and then we don't do anything with the third variable. And finally, the first and second variables are set so that the clause does not become satisfied, and the third one is set so that it does become satisfied. These are the 3 possible cases with 3-sat, since there are at most 3 variables in any clause. Now you can write any additional functions required to solve this problem or break this up into subparts, and I'd recommend doing that. It should make this much simpler because it can get to be quite a bit of code here. So have fun solving 3-sat. I know we've already done a lot of the steps.